It's Ladies' Day at Fort Stockton, Texas. All the fellas can do today is look as the good lookers strut their stuff in the all-girl rodeo. These Lone Star cow gals get things going with a grand parade in real Wild West style. Bareback bronc riding is just her dish. Well, they can't all stay on. Out west, where men are men and the steers are ornery, a gal accepts her fate gracefully and hasn't a beef coming. Sometimes these mean critters lull you into a sense of false security. Yeah, there's nothing to it. Mister, that is the end. That All-American pastime, baseball, brings out the All-American Girl Baseball League for spring training at Alexandria, Virginia. Two teams are working out, the Fort Wayne Daisies and the Racine Belles, getting in shape for an opening day doubleheader. Dottie Schroeder is quite confident that her hair won't get in her eyes. And keeping her eye on the ball is catcher Kate Vonderau. Okay, gals, play ball. Pat Scott has quite a curve, but this one is wide, and Jean Marlow is willing to wait. Jean bunts it, the squeeze is on. Timmy Eisen slides home with a run and a nicely bruised leg. Better a bruise than long pants, eh, gals? Joe Weaver hits the long ball, almost out of the ballpark. Boy, that clears the base paths. And inside the park, homer by a whisker. The spotlight is on the Penn relays and the Ben Franklin mile. Stuart Ray sets the pace for the first half mile, but the big names of the race are Roger Bannister of England and Don Gurman and Fred Wilt of the U.S. 40,000 see the long-striding medical student from Oxford take the lead and keep it in a convincing display of all-around power. Wilt, the flying G-man, is staying right with the young Britisher, temporarily. Hailed as the Empire's best miler since the late Jack Lovelock, Bannister lives up to his advanced billing. He gives Uncle Sam's best a long-range view of his flying heels as he sprints the last quarter and beats Wilt to the tape by 15 yards and Gurman by 30. His time is 4:08.3, a new record for the Penn Relays and new laurels for Roger Bannister from England.
You know, there are plenty of good investments in this country, but I have one permanent share that no money can buy. My share in the United States of America. We are all shareholders getting priceless dividends every day just from being American. In this bountiful land, land of freedom, free press, free speech, freedom to gripe about what we don't like, freedom to change it, freedom to worship God, not the head man whose picture's on every wall, America, land of opportunity with a great future. For the future belongs to the free man, not the slave. You know, when I think of these things, and the hundreds of millions of people around the world who live in want and fear, I say to myself, brother, how lucky you are. This is your country. Defend it. It's your freedom. Protect it. It's your future. Build for it. Save for it. Buy shares in it. Sign up for the payroll savings where you work. Buy United States defense bonds regularly and hold on to them.